Okay, hello everybody. Here is a tutorial to help you make a keyring with your name using Shapr3D. Looks a little bit like this. If it's in focus, let's try that again. Looks a little bit like this. So we're going to select an interesting font to spell out our names. Then we're going to create a body to put around the design as well. So hopefully that makes sense. Alrighty, so for this activity we need Shapr, and to get interesting fonts you need a program called Creative Cloud. You should have access to Creative Cloud if you have a Photoshop account. The school, if you're doing graphics, you should have access. So you can download this and log in with your school email. Alrighty, so here we go. So to create a key ring, the first thing we need to do is look at our unit of measurement, make sure it's set to millimeters. Because we're going to click on the top of the view cube, sketch, and create a rectangle. All right, and we're going to set the size of this rectangle to 30 by 30. Alrighty, 30 by 30, 30 millimeters by 30 millimeters. This is just so that we have an idea of how big our keyring will be. We don't want it to be bigger than that because it'll be a gigantic keyring. We don't want it to be smaller than that because it'll be too small. So that's a good size, right? Now this rectangle is a reference. What we make can be slightly bigger, slightly smaller. It's just there to give us an idea of how big things should be. All right, now we're going to go like this. Add text. We can type our name. Yeah, type our name. It's important when we type our name, two things, right? It's important that we choose a font that's nice, that has nice, clean, thick letters. If we choose a really thin font with scrolly letters like this, when we 3D print the key ring, the 3D printer can't really work with a font like that. It'll be too thin, too small, and it just won't look good. So what we need is to find a font that's got really clean, thick, chunky letters. So normally, if you look in your list of fonts, you won't have many interesting fonts. You want to get more creative designer fonts than what's in this list already. So this is where Creative Cloud comes in. If you click on the fonts part of Creative Cloud, there are all these different custom types of fonts that are available. So look at this, Grave Blade. You have like a heavy metal font. You have what's this sort of font? A scratchy sort of cartoon font. So we're gonna look through here and find an interesting thick font. We don't want a font that's got like a effect like this with a drop shadow. You want just a nice, clean, thick font. Let's go. Let's have a look real quick. Just looking for one that catches my eye. How about let's get back up the top. I might go with the heavy metal font just because. All right, where was the heavy metal one? Grave Blade. Okay, I'm gonna go with Grave Blade for my font. Click the little download arrow. All right, this processes, takes a second. It's downloading from the cloud. All right, remember the name of your font, Grave Blade. Okay, all good. Now go back to Shaper, and from your menu, you should be able to find Grave Blade in the menu. All right, now What we want to do also is change the size of the font to something that's just big enough to fit inside the 30 by 30 shape. So if I reckon if I go 7, that's good enough. Click continue. Okay, I'll use my arrows to move my letters up. Right, there we go. Cool beans, right? It's roughly about the right size. Click done. Now that you've got the let, also move the letters outside of the square. Click the letters and extrude by 4. Deselect. Click the letters. So you've got to make sure you click well inside the letters. If you tap the edge of the letters, it makes you, the program thinks you want to edit the sketch, not the letters. All right, there we go. 2 extrusions, 4 millimeters wide. All right, we've created our text. Here's something that will help you, right? I am done with this sketch now. If I keep this sketch plane number 1, it's going to interfere with other things I do. So whenever I do a sketch like this and I'm done, I swipe right and delete. Another thing I'm going to do is really quick, I might go like this. Double tap my name, drag it so that it's closer to my second name. Awesome. And then I'm going to select all of these bodies by clicking the little squares in the bottom left-hand corner and add them to a folder. All right, that's useful. That's useful when I want to make another extrusion. I don't want these bodies to interfere with my second extrusion. All righty, now, there we go. Looks cool, fantastic. I'm gonna create a sketch. Make sure I'm looking at the top. I'm gonna begin by creating a circle. All right, 4 millimeters seems cool for that circle. That's going to be the hole the key ring will go through. My second will be 7. Okay, I want a nice strong ring for my key ring, so I'm going to make it 3 millimeters thicker. Then I'm going to grab the line tool and randomly make shape to fit my name inside. Click trim to get rid of this. Exit sketch because I'm done. All right, so this is what I was talking about with the folder. All right, if I tap this body now and extrude, it's not actually selecting the holes inside the letters, right? It's selecting outside of the letters, not the whole thing at once. So what I want to do is turn the body off, select 3, okay, because I want the body will be 3, the letters will be 4, so there's a difference. All right, and if I turn it back on, I can see it's selected it all at once now, so that's cool, right? Much better. Okay, so instead of having to go through and select the inside of the O, the D, all sorts of stuff, I can select it all at once by hiding the folder with the bodies. Sketch plane number 1 is there again. Delete that because I don't need it. All right, last thing I'm going to do is click the corners here, and I'm going to use the fillet function to round off the edges. So I type 2 to round off the edges, and I might be extra clever. Click here, click this line, and I'll fillet that by 1, right, to give it an effect like that. Cool beans, right? We've got our letters, we've got our body, we've got our ring. This is ready to be 3D printed. Last thing I need to do is send it to me, to Mr. Doherty, to 3D print in the correct format. So if you look up in the top, very top of the program, the little upwards arrow, tap on that. Here's your different export options. You want to select 3D print, and you want to click on the top one, STL. Right, call it your name, keyring, return, continue, save to your files, and you've got a keyring in the correct format to be 3D printed. All right, there you go. Good luck.